He thinks he's funny. He thinks he's really funny. I'll get him back.
Hey guys, Amanda from Rock Pile Homestead here. Today, Corey and I are going to take advantage of this beautiful day. We're going to head out in Rocky. So I noticed there was some trees fallen along one of the lower tracks by the creek. There's also some baby trees that are coming up. So the fallen trees need to be cleared and the baby trees need to be moved. Hopefully we can transplant them. Corey is just sharpening the chainsaw at the moment. We'll grab the whippersnipper and some shovels and we'll get to work. So we've got whippersnipper, chainsaw, axe. Here we've got a little stash of extra whippersnipper wire, protein snips. Down here, these are some snippets strap around your legs. Rake, shovel. These are my rake and shovel. Corey's got his own favourite shovel, which is not in the car yet. I don't know if he's going to go get that.
Who's doing the shoveling? I don't use your shovel, and you're not using mine. 1982 Hilux. Ready? First pop, I bet you it'll start.
So this is down along the creek line, the very bottom of our property. You see this whole section here doesn't have any trees, they've been cleared, and there's like a thicker woodlands further down the creek line. So we want to try to regenerate this area. You see these little baby trees that are coming up through the track that I was talking about. Through here that have seeded. That'll be eucalypts. And we've got 1, 2, 3 trees that have come down that we need to sort out.
Yeah, so we think that the water kind of disappears to like an underground stream or back into the aquifer down there near our dam. So what we're going to try and do is we think we're going to cut some trees, some logs, foliage, all sorts of stuff, and we're going to attempt to make a mound, is that the right word? Make something in a certain section of this creek, so on the water coming in, and hopefully soak this land a bit more and see if that helps. Trial and error. We'll see how we go. So I'm just going to go get the whippersnipper and give this area a little chop up with it, just so we can have a better look. We think this might be the go. I use a blade I made on the whippersnipper. Just got these laser cut, drew them up, got them cut. They're made out of Hardox 700 or something, some sort of hardware plate. They go straight on. This is a little bit broken here, but that's fine. And they last forever. Just don't hit any rocks with it. My one of choice is the Dolma 115i. Seems to be just a powerhouse of a saw. It's old, but it's a bloody ripper. It is. Thank you. Yes.
So we've got this big one left.
Yeah, I reckon we
should. Do that on top.
Do that on top.
Okay.
And then maybe we get those two bales of hay.
And put them on their hole.
And we put just.
Oh, yeah.
On, even if we break them up and just kind of fill this bit in. Yeah? Anyway, chuck us that big log. And just chuck it down. Not on me.
Hey.
Alright, that is good.
So what we're going to do is we're going to take advantage of the potential extra water in this area. We're going to dig up some of those baby trees that are on the track that we need to remove anyway. And we'll plant them beside this creek line and give them a better chance of growing up and maturing.
Been meaning to do this for a while, and that's cut a tap in down here. I do have this one, but we have a one-way valve here to stop the line from backflowing, so I'm just going to cut this this in. Can't actually remember what these are called. It's a tapping saddle. So it just clamps onto the pipe, boom, little O-ring seals it, and then I'll drill a hole through there, screw that in, and we'll have water, and I'll probably get drenched along the way.
That's not a knife.
This is just some water base pipe O-ring seal, lubricant rather. So I'll just put some on there. Fine for the waterways, it's nothing. Make sure there's no debris on here. And then that will screw in there, and we'll put our hose on and we can fill our water. Now I've just got to drill a hole. Without getting too wet. I gotta say, that was fresh. I wasn't expecting that. I thought it was just gonna trickle out. All right, tap done, and you can see we just turn it on, and we have water backflowing from that pipe. As I said, that's just gravity flow coming from the what's in the pipe, in a couple of hundred meters of pipe. It'll be enough to water these trees that we're putting in.
Measuring up some cardboard to go around the trees. Cardboard, dry grasses to use as mulch around these trees. Got some old straw bales which we've put on the back of our little beaver dam. Got that side, I'm just going to go through and water them. I'll give you a bit of a closer look before he's watering. Got a little tree cut down in there with the cardboard around it. Mulch on top of the cardboard. And then some cut timber logs just to give it a bit of a protection, a natural protection. Working as something of a like tree shield. So that's he thinks he's funny. He thinks he's really funny. I'll get him back. That's one beaver dam built. 16 trees replanted. Hopefully they'll take off, and we'll monitor the progress for this creek regen project. Thanks for joining us today, guys.
That was pretty fresh. Felt like Hugh Jackman then.
If you want to see more of our content, please hit the thumbs up, click subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified whenever we drop a new video. Cheers, guys.